Hello, I'm Prof. LOUIE from HKUST. Today I'm going to introduce the subject area of zero emission local ferries. Why this subject is important? Well, traditionally, when we talk about air quality improvement, control measures, typically we talk about controlling emissions of vehicles, use of electric vehicles, reducing emissions of marine vessels, emission control of power plants, and of course, tightening the standards. Of course, regional collaboration is important as well. But today, I'm going to focus more on the marine emission. Why this is important? As you can see from this slide, that globally, the marine emissions affecting a lot of coastal cities. In China, 7 out of the 10 busiest ports are within China. So we need to do more to control the marine emission. But of course, the opportunity, I would say, lies with the very good GBA development plan. Why this is important? These plans opens a very important door for Hong Kong be part of this action within the Greater Bay Area. This plan, believe it or not, every single word is important. It gives not just the technical development, finance, and a lot of action can be developed from the GBA plan. The, of course, green shipping is part of this plan. Why? Because I don't see this as just a development plan development, because it represents for the marine trade a golden opportunity for finance, be it green tech, green bond, and investment opportunities. Now, of course, today we are talking about zero emissions, meaning that the battery technology is important. Why this is important? Well, it's zero emission. That some may argue that, well, you still have some emission from power plant, and then you have to take into account of that, but that's a separate subject area. Today, a lot of new development are happening in Europe. Certainly, we can learn a lot from our European counterparts. But the main message here is not just on the technical fund or financial fund. The main message is that we can all collaborate in this very exciting opportunity. With that, I thank you very much for your attention. Well, I would like to take this opportunity to convert some of the conceptual ideas to reality. And I'm fortunate today to have my friend Woody to tell us more about the challenges and opportunity. Woody.
大家好, OK. 环保船首先说环保船的优点就是说能降低营运成本包括维修费用减低那个燃油费用容易降下来然后那个减少环境污染因为它在运行里面呢噪音是非常低的对海洋生态影响应该是相对减少
Woody, can you tell us a little bit more about the challenges we face with this zero emission ship?
另外有一个很大的挑战就是说现在的蓄电池那个费用比较高 OK 因为影响那个一些传动那个投资第二呢续航力可能更柴油机比的话就是说没有这么远相对在那个远海那个船那个操作有一些难度第三呢就是说岸上充电的问题啊海上充电的问题啊因为不仅它的没有发动机没有发电机是零排放的概念希望能够在将来能够解决充电的问题续航力的问题这个环保船就算是成功了
OK
好 OK
Many thanks Woody
OK 好谢谢各位
to move the idea forward, I have the opportunity today to consult our friend Ray about the safety design and the experience from our European counterparts. Ray, can you tell us more?
首先我想跟 Peter 分享一下几个数字。 就是说我们在航运占我们全球的一个温室排放的一个这个排放量的话 大概是2.5%左右 然后这几年那个国际海事组织还有我们的欧盟的话提出了非常严格的一个要求法规的要求然后国际海事组织这边的话是要求在全球的一个海运的一个二氧化碳排放量要在2008年的时候减少到50%。 在这方面的话，欧盟提出了更高的要求，所以我们业界正在讨论一种比较低碳环保的一个替代的一个燃料。Peter，您刚今天提出来的一个零排放的传播的这个概念，就是一个非常重要的一个概念。然后针对这种零排放的一个技术的话，我们业界也在讨论LNG啊、甲醇啊、LPG啊，甚至太阳能啊、蓄电池。 作为最比较重要的一个动力技术，同时这种蓄电池的技术的话，也是一种，在欧洲已经比较形成规模了。它证明了是一种比较行之有效的一种手段。对，然后关于这个安全方面的话，因为这是个新的一个技术，电池我们都知道是有一定的风险的。 所以这个关于电池怎么管控它的一个危险性，所以我们在作为传奇社来讲，我们需要一个 case by case 去 study 这个 scenario， 然后我们去那个针对每一个项目，我们会有一个跟我们的船东还有我们的一个 operator 会比较深入的探讨，根据这个船的一个运营特性，还有它的一个电池的一个布置的情况。 我们给这个船去设计，去审核它特定的一个，譬如是消防方面的一个要求，还有它的电池储存的一个要求，甚至它的一个电池能源管理的一个要求。对，就是。
Well, that's very good, Ray. I appreciate your input in this very important subject area. Thank you.
Thank you.